Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Super Monday Night Combat, a commentary! Finally, I played for like a billion, trillion, gazillion years, and I finally managed to get a Spark gameplay. I finally managed to also get a Commando gameplay, so jubilation and huzzas all around. Let's throw a parade because holy shit, it took fucking a really long time for me to learn the classes and sort of learn the Commando mindset. I was very much not privy to it from the beginning, and I did very, very horribly. I did my best not to feed, but all it took was one grapple and a competent team, and I was a dead man, so... I mean, I guess that's true for most classes, but some of them can kind of, you know, outlive that, or because they got a lot of health, but two grapples and you're done, son, so... Anyways, I finally got a gameplay, so here it is, and of course, why wouldn't it be on Locomoco? It's, yeah... expect a grenade 3.14 video soon. I have one now I might do. It's not the best score, but it's actually gameplay of the map, so... Who knows? I might get a better one before that happens, so... Anyways, I got quite a bit of gameplay saved up, because I got to play a little bit while my girlfriend's brother was visiting, but I didn't get to commentate a lot, because, I could play while they were in, he was in the room, because he would be playing Call of Duty, but I couldn't really commentate, because I'd feel like an asshole, so. Anyways, first things first, I go into the jungle, and that was right there, that lunge was a mistake, but I go into the jungle, I try to hide behind that, not let them see me, but that didn't fucking work. So if they had not seen me, I could have went about my business unmolested. Now, I think I do get the gremlin, which is the whole reason I was up here. I don't really give a shit about any of these people. I just wanted that fucking gremlin. So, at this point, I'm going to drop down into the lane. I don't know why I went after the tank. I guess my team was there, and I kind of wanted to flip switch him back behind me. He has a lot of health. He's got his shield up, but if my teammates decided to help out, then he could have been dead, so... It really, really relied heavily on the fact that my team had some sort of a cohesion, but... Early game, I just like to take out all the slims with Spark, and I get in here and I build up the fucking alt fire, and then I use it. I don't know why I didn't keep it for against the pro, but I don't understand how that works. Like, because oftentimes I'll just use it and nothing comes out and no damage happens. It's a little bit buggy, but sometimes when I mash it, it works better than just literally trying to use it. Now I see the gremlin right there, and that's once again why I came up here. Just to take this gremlin, and also because I get a bird's eye view of all the action, and I get a better idea of what to do. I'm looking around. I drop down back in the lane because I don't know entirely sure why. I guess just like I want them to think, hey, this is where I am, and then once they think, oh, that's where he is, then I will leave, and they'll go, oh, well, last time I checked, that Spark was in the lane shooting his ray gun, and then I'll be like, surprise, bitch, and I'd jump down from the fucking heft. Oh, my God. I can't believe I just used X-Cal's... Oh my God, it feels like such a fucking douchebag. Use his catchphrase, alright. I jumped out from them and I'm like, hello, fine chap, you are quite startled. And then I'll start wailing on him with my lightning stick. But yeah, so that's what I like to do. And I like to just kill... This is like the thing, basically the main thing that I did too much as a commando. It was just, I just focused too hard on the bots. But early game, I don't really want to fucking get too fancy. And also, I'm kind of looking for somebody to start to retreat or to have, like, about half health. And then I'm going to jump down and just rain destruction on their domes. Now, I believe I have one investment in defense, one in offense, and one in arc flash. And right here is a good reason to have... Oh, no! It didn't work. Right there, that's really tricky. Whenever you arc flash, try to aim it up a little bit. It works a lot better if you just basically look almost straight up and then jump and then use it. Because there's nothing up there for you to get caught on, but right there you can see that I teleported right through that into that wall, and not a whole lot of things happened. So that happened to me a bunch on this map, is that I would teleport and bad things occurred. Now that guy's gonna jump back onto the map. I knew he would, but I don't chase because I don't want to have to deal with one, I'm getting hit by that stupid fucking turret, and two, I don't want the whole team to come over and start grapple chaining me. And that's exactly what would have happened if I had sort of pursued, because they were right all there. And also, there was a laser blaze there. Last thing I needed to do is to be jettisoned into that. Now, this guy's a dumbass. I'm going to throw him away. Go get away from your teammates. Yeah, you're done. Now I'm going to get the fuck away. I don't know. No. Okay, there we go. Oftentimes, what I'll do is I'll try to to arc flash even when I'm blinded. Just hope that I go in a good direction. Go like a, oh my god, no! Nightcrawler style in the movie where he's like, I can only go where I can see. I'm like, well, not me, son. I go wherever the fuck I want. Now, this guy is being a dummy. He sees me coming from like 1,000 years and decides to fuck around. And right here, I wouldn't recommend what I'm doing, and I'm playing a very grapple-heavy spark. I recommend just holding that M1 down, because the assassin really requires her grapples to do the beef of her damage. But the spark very much is the opposite. Also, if you're just jumping around and M1-ing, it makes it much harder for you to grapple. If you grapple somebody, all they have to do is wait for your grapple to end, then run up, and then they've grappled you, and that's bad news. That's one of the reasons that Assassin has to be incredibly crafty with how she goes about her business. Now this guy, he's almost dead, but he also's got juice. So I don't want to get close to him and have him juice on me. And if my goal is right here is to grapple him and make him waste his juice. But I noticed that I'm getting wrecked right now. I go ahead and juice and to put out the fire. And I figured I could definitely kill him if I just back away and ray gun him, because he was just charging straight at me like a dope, thought he had me. And he was doing very minimal damage with his jet gun at that range, so I decided that would be a good idea. Now, I thought that the gunner was fighting the Carl, but apparently he was fighting the assassin, so I kind of ran over there for no reason. That was kind of a mistake there, was to blind her. What you should do is basically blind them afterwards, as opposed to during your grapple. Like, I went up, I had completely the element of surprise. I could have grappled her without doing it. I sort of wasted it because it's really good for stripping armor and for like blinding enemies while you grapple a different one, but it's very much not good for blinding a single enemy. Get off the map. I'm getting him off just so we can, there'll be one less person up there. He has to go and take forever to get back fucking up there. I try to grapple him just holding his place because I know my teammates are nearby. I go ahead and this basically what I do for this anti-fight is I jump up there, and then I just jump back down immediately. And oftentimes, Spark is not necessarily going to need to be at the end. He doesn't need to be up there. What you can do is really just push the shit out of lanes by yourself. And the only reason I was up there because I had no idea what my teammates were doing. I had no idea their competence level. And since they're all down here, I'm most certainly not going to go up there by myself as a squishy asshole that I am. So I'm like, fine, we're going to push lanes. If that's what this is, then that's what it is, all right? And so I see that these guys over there, right there, that's a little trick. If you go ahead and jump right after you roll, I don't know the timing on it, but if you jump immediately afterwards, you'll get a huge boost. And I learned that from watching a video, and also learned it by accidentally doing it and jumping off the map several hundreds of thousands of times. So make sure you only jump when you really, really want to travel that distance. This guy's a fucking idiot. He runs out of the cloak right as he comes into the turrets and gets massacred. What a dope. Lose the Annie because we pretty much gave up on it. We could have easily won it, but my team refused to go up there. So now this guy's I just did it right there to slow him down, because I know that it also slows. I believe I could be mistaken, but I was on the impression that it did. Now this guy, he gets the churro, so I'm annoyed by that, but it doesn't matter to me because I'm just gonna M1 him to death. And right there, that's basically what you want to do is jump in M1. I did a poor job of positioning myself. Like, I was basically in front of him the whole time. What you're gonna want to do is get to their sides, get behind them. Do all that stuff, because if you're basically just jumping at them up and down and right into their face, what they can very easily do is just mash grab and you'll land right into the grab. So what you want to do is you want to be very erratic with your jumps whenever you're M1-ing them the shit out of them in point blank range. And that goes identically for if there's a commando coming at you trying to grapple the shit out of you. And right here, me and that assault go ahead and double juice the shit out of that. And I go ahead and put a few rounds in their backs, but not a whole lot comes from it. Oh boy, what was the thing I was talking about? No! I do this so often, and I feel like such a dick if you're like, what's really, really good strategy with support is to just radically jump in all directions, not straight back, and just hurt gun. Because if they're very stupid, they'll just, like, if they're an assassin, they're going to constantly spam grapple because they can't really adequately do a lot of damage to you. But if they're big baddies, if they're big, bad, stupid, Sparks, what they'll do instead of M1-ing the shit out of you. No, get him! Aw, damn it. I really wanted to grapple him and throw him away. Now, right here, I definitely wanted to M1 that guy. And I wanted to throw him off the map, but I really didn't get the opportunity. Now, I kind of wasted that teleport, mostly because I lost track of him immediately. Like, I wanted to run over there and help, but I immediately lost track of him. But I get the kill in the end, but if he had any sense, he would have just ran away instead of just jumping to the roof like a fucking idiot. So Man, I'm getting arbitrarily aggressive against somebody who may just be learning a class. Just ignore me, because I did the exact same things. I was a big idiot, just teleporting into walls and shit, and so. But anyways, erratic jumping is your friend whenever you're fighting commandos or whenever they're, you are a commando, so remember that. Don't just jump, don't just back away in a straight line, because it'll make it really easy for you to get grappled, and don't just run at them in a straight line. Just jump to the side, maybe just back off a little bit, then roll into them. Do things like that, because if you're just really predictable with your jumps, you're going to get shit on. And I know, because that happened whenever I played the character. Now, these guys are fucking... Shadies are bigger pain in the ass, I think, than Fujis whenever you play as Spark, because whenever you're taking out a Fuji by, like, you're just by yourself, it's really easy. Now, I'm going to take out this tank. Guess what, tank? You're dead, Zo. No, get him! I got the Inspire heal, and I would recommend that on you guys. I wouldn't necessarily recommend a Hot Hands on Spark, because you don't need it. He gets a lot of damage from just attacking, and his grapple isn't. His grapple is mainly for the utility of throwing them off the map. It does a lot of damage, but you can do a lot of damage with your primary, and also you don't have to really worry about getting locked in place. So, I would not recommend Hot Hands on the Spark. So. Really, the only benefit that it gives you at this point is that if somebody low health grapples you, it'll kill them. But other than that, I would recommend other products. Let's see, what other products would I recommend? Right now, I got Inspire, which I would very much recommend because it allows you to do things like what I did before, is like play like a huge shithead and take out that tank, and it heals a lot. Inspire heals a lot on commandos because they have such shit health that whenever you get like an Inspire heal, it'll heal like 25% of your health, whereas if you're in a force, it heals like almost nothing. Now, see, this guy is almost dead. Guess what, dude? I missed the grapple right here. No, I don't. I land it. I could have just... And then he jumps and dies, so... But I really... He was pinned in the corner. I could have just held M1 and killed him, but I kind of wanted the grapple kill for, like, a little bit more money. That's I guess, a benefit to... actually, it's not a benefit to using Hot Hands, because they don't die from the grapple kill. They die from the fire if the whole point of Hot Hands is to use it to increase damage, so... But yeah, oftentimes if you can safely grapple kill somebody, go ahead, because it gives you more money. And that's not a whole lot, but it's better than nothing. But yeah, Spark, you can just get by with all that all that M1ing. So, but you have to. It really relies heavily on teamwork, or the lack of teamwork. Now this guy, I really should have just snuck up on him instead of just wailing on him. I don't think I would have snuck up on him, because I think he caught on to me before I was even hitting him. But I just recommend doing it because. If you start wailing on them, then they'll basically take evasive action. But if you just run up and grapple them, they won't know what hit them. You might be able to get in one or two swipes real fast, because his swipes are really fast. Right there, boom! That's why grapples aren't very good whenever you're in team fight. We lose another Annihilator, because I fucking was focusing on that assassin, as was the rest of my team, as opposed to the Annihilator or the lane. So that was my fault. I really should have been. Should have been either in lane or up there on the Annihilator. I could have, the assassin probably wouldn't have died if I hadn't grappled her, because I don't think anybody else was in a position to grapple her. And now I back the fuck off. The one thing annoying about Leo's turret is that it doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but it's got really good range, which I guess is acceptable considering the fact that he can't really buff it like combat girl can or the support can. Now right there, I'm very stupid, and I just sort of let her grapple me. Now we both go for the churro. I land it. I go ahead and I blind her again, and I get off the kick flip, and at this point, I know she's going to escape, but I couldn't do anything about it because I do not know what I'm doing with commandos. Rogue Blades would have been a cool guy and teleported after her and totally been awesome. I sneak up on this guy and I grapple him. What I should have done was flip switched him, because then he wouldn't have been near this jump pad, but he very stupidly doesn't take it anyways. If he had taken it up to the top and then jumped down and floated for fucking ever, there's nothing I could have done about it, but he drops down to like my level. That's if you're playing Leo, get the high ground and then just jump and fly across America like you're fucking Aladdin. Do that. I can show you the world. Do that shit. Don't jump down where everybody can hit you with fucking swords and bullets and shit and ray guns. Oh no! Right there is one of those instances where I got blinded. It's like one of those instances where like you're in a room, you close your eyes, and you can kind of navigate the room because you had your eyes open momentarily. It's like that. where I saw before I was blinded, and I knew exactly where to go, which was straight ahead. Now, right here, I go ahead and get juice. I pop the juice so I had to put out the fire damage. And I go ahead, I let him have the churros. He's not getting away. He's already burned his charge to try to kill me. I just do a very bad job of spacing, so he kind of gets away a little bit, but he dies eventually. But I juice there mainly to put out the fire so that it wouldn't be doing ongoing damage. And also to sort of back him up, because a juice spark does a fucking ridiculous amount of damage. It's really stupid. Like, oftentimes I would just recommend saving it to break grapples, but depending on the situation, spark with juice could be just evil, how huge the DPS is. Now, I hold off on ejecting until the Fuji bot's right in the middle, and that takes it out. I decided to push a little bit with the ray gun and with the ejector, just because I want to get our lanes cleared up so that they're on the defensive, and when they're on the defensive, I can sneak up on them much easier. I go ahead and grapple that guy while he was... Oh, no! Oh, I die. That's why you don't grapple. That's just M1. But I grappled him because he was low life, and he was also trying to grapple me. And since he was spamming grapple, then he wasn't in the air jumping and avoiding my grapple. So I landed easy. The one thing that I kind of wanted was the inspire health from killing him, but the kill got stolen. And I typed in my chat, "Hey guys, could you not steal kills if I'm grappling people? I like to have the inspire kill." But for whatever reason, it didn't appear in chat. It might have appeared in chat, and mine might have glitched out for whatever reason, so they saw it, but I didn't. Or maybe nobody saw it, but either way, I asked them to no avail, so I was like, ah, fuck it, I'm not gonna bother, because it's clearly not working. Somebody just got ejected. I saw them. Right there, I see the Leo super low health. Oh, he gets killed. Now I see this Carl. There's no way he doesn't see me. I go ahead and I blind him, and then I make him waste his prop hop. Because, oh god, no! Right there, the tank is fucking huge against commandos. And I know this because I play as tank. So if a tank comes at you, that's one of the main reasons. If you're playing a match and there's a tank, you know what you don't do? You don't ever fuck around with less than full health. Because one charge in Death Blossom and you're fucking dead. Even if you're... The only way that's not going to happen is if he's vastly underleveled. And the likelihood of that is little to none. Especially a mid to late game. Because a mid to late game tank is a fucking beast at leveling up. Because he takes out bot waves ridiculous. Now right here, I throw the chest and into my teammates. I'm like, hey, guess what? Oh no! The Carl starts to hit me, so I fly away. I teleport away. And I'm like, I gotta get out of here. Bamf. I bamf out of the fucking way. Carl is another pro that can really shit right in your head whenever you're full health. Even if you're full health, you gotta be very, very, very cautious whenever you're playing as Carl, or playing against Carl, and you're playing against a tank, because a tank, all a tank needs is EM2, and you're hurting like a motherfucker, especially if you don't have any goddamn points in defense like you should. Now, see this guy. I see the gunner was up there, and I figured he would stick around and help, but he doesn't, but that's okay, because, oh no, what's happening? Ah, man, I let the Carl get away, but if that gunner had just stuck around, then it probably wouldn't have been a big deal. I don't know if he was low health, but even if he was, like, whenever it's a 2-on-1, if you're low health, kind of, like, to run away, but also fucking stick around to help. Right there, I back away because I'm low health, but I'm still engaged. I know what's going on, and at that point, I just give up because they're all at the Annie again, and none of my team is, so I'm like, fuck it, we're not going to... Annie, we're going to go for the bots, then I'm going to juice to take out a bunch of bots. And I kind of wasted the juice because I should have used it right here against these two Fujis, because that would have been a better use of my juice. But the spark is also amazing at bot pushing, assuming nobody else is in the lane. Like, for example, this instance right here. I go ahead and run away. I get annihilated. I teleport. I don't know what I was doing. I don't know why I took forever to teleport, but I did nonetheless, so... I back away, and I noticed that we pushed the lanes really fucking far, so I don't even have to worry about shooting down lane, but oftentimes a little trick I'll do is, I'll just, like, as I'm backing away to buy bots, I'll shoot all the way down lane, like if I'm Megabeth or Spark. That way, I mean, it's a projectile, it's not hitscan, so the time it's taking to get down there, maybe eventually a bot will sort of walk into it, and then you can poop all over the head. Now right here, I pull my head out of my ass, and I decide, oh no! I teleport poorly. Oh god, I got so scared. No, no, no. Okay, phew. Now I'm going to lose a lot of health to burn damage, which is why Asbestos! Maybe use Asbestos instead of Hot Hands on Spark. That's what I recommend. Use Asbestos. It puts a kibosh and tank ruin in your day. It ruins Hot Hands for assassins. And so it makes you the hot shit commando of the match. So yeah. Oh boy, what was I talking about? Oh yeah, they're in that chest and I decided not to grapple. And it wisely paid off because I crinked my neck 40 degrees to the left and noticed, oh, their whole fucking team! Now notice this Cheston is being a big dummy. He's getting killed. Is he gonna kill him? You gonna kill him? Oh wait, no, the Cheston wasn't a dummy. The Leo was a dummy. Wait, what happened? I wasn't paying attention. Anyways, I got a kill because somebody was low health and I noticed it. Now I have my ray gun out and I fired it. If you can basically get off a point blank ray gun, just aim at their ankles a little bit. Aim maybe to their knees, and you can kind of splash damage them a little bit. It's got a tiny little bit of a radius. But, yeah, you can, it's, what else are you going to do? It takes too long to switch weapons to actually do damage. So go ahead and give one little fire. Megan! Yeah! But give him one little fire of the ray gun, then switch to your weapon. Sometimes, depending on what class they are, you can go ahead and ray gun them to death, especially if they're low health. Makes it, it's just a lot easier, just hit them with two ray guns as opposed to try to run after them and, as they run away to safety and try to fucking melee them to death, so. But if their class is going to escape, I recommend one shot from the ray gun and then switch to your primary and then try to hit them just with one swipe. Oh, you dickhead, get out of my face with that shit. I lose all my armor from that mean bouncer. I don't know really why I was fighting it. I didn't need the 200 bucks. I'm pretty high leveled as it is. So, Carl, prop pops. No! We just switched places. I'm very stupid. I see that tank is low health, but it's too late. I'm not going to be able to get to him before he gets into his base. I back up because they're scramblers, and scramblers are a commando's like a worst nightmare. Holy shit. Like, scramblers, sure, they're a pain in the ass whenever you play as a... as an enforcer, but holy shit are they annoying as a commando, because you lose your lunge, you lose basically what makes you the most mobile class in the game, and now you're just a shitty enforcer. That's all it is, you're a shitty version of an enforcer without your mobility tools. So I go ahead and throw this guy towards the, oh actually not really towards my teammates. I thought I would stick around, but apparently I ran away. Now this is why you don't take on a juice spark. Look at that, I melted that guy, it took nothing. No, I didn't have to do shit. I go hit him with a juice to whatever the alt fire is. I didn't think it would kill him, but why the fuck not, you know? You might as well do it. You only live once. YOLO! Oh, God. Yeah, you only live once, so go ahead and... Well, not in Super Monday Combat. You die, and then they reborn you because you're a clone of some bunch of DNA and shit. I don't remember how that... I don't know how the mythology of this game works. Leave me alone. See this guy? I'm gonna go ahead and make him burst. Oh fuck! He used his juice. Never mind. I really wanted to make him burn his juice by grappling him, but he went ahead and used it first. So now I'm gonna back up and not get hit by juice. Goddamn ballista, whatever it's called, because it does a bunch of damage. I really fucking hate his stupid crossbow. It's really annoying because here's the reason why. Because when enemies use it against me, it does a bunch of damage. Oh no, tank, run away! That's what you want to do. Tank comes at you, run away instantly. Don't stick around, because he's already burst damaged the shit out of you. There's no reason for you to stick around. And right here, I'm looking for an adequate time to get health. I want to buy it from theirs, but I don't because it's kind of dangerous. And also, there's a bouncer, so I run away. I'm going to come up here. I hear Chicky Candace here, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get this juice. I'm going to take one of them, let my gunner have one. Now, what I should do is stick around and get the... grapple kill! Yeah! Oh, I got an assist because of the... What did I get this for? Oh, I guess rockets. I let the gunner have... one of the juices, what I should have done was stick around for Chicky Cantor and just get churros in order to heal myself, but I kind of was already full health anyway, so I didn't really have to worry about it. And this time I'm like, fuck it, we're not losing this goddamn Annihilator. I don't burst juice here because I want to keep it for breaking a grapple up here so I can just be really annoying and be a little bit too, oh no, I missed that lunge. I wanted to lunge onto that platform and sort of shit on his head, but it didn't work. I get my grapple off on this guy, I'm going to get some burn damage on him, and I'm going to hold on to my juice for as long as I can, because if I'm up here and they grapple me, I can juice and just immediately get the fuck away, but if I juice to do damage and they grapple me, I've just wasted my juice. Now, right there, they make my goddamn, it make my buying that Regenerol obsolete, plus I couldn't buy it anyways. Now this guy, I don't know what he's doing, but I go ahead and I grapple him, which was a mistake right there, because the tank goes ahead and starts to be a cool guy. Now right there, I did my juice to stop the burn from killing me, from doing additional damage, as well as to sort of push everybody away. And it works out in the end because, where'd the fucking Carl go? I missed him! I think he's behind me, I don't know, but it doesn't matter because I let him go because I don't care about the kill. I wanted to get the Annihilator, and if we're not going to get the Annihilator, I at least want to push these bots back. So I did a bunch of work, I assumed my team would get the Annihilator. I go ahead and grapple this tank. Because he burned all of his juice, all of his jump jet, avoiding the blind. That's something you might want to invest in doing. Is if you see an enforcer, go ahead and blind them and just see how they react. Because if they just jump jet, wait for their jump jet to end and then grapple them. And after you've grappled them, they have literally no jump jet. So you can easily double grapple them, triple grapple them if you're a vet. No vet doesn't have a blind, but you know, if your teammate picks Spark or Assassin, they'll have a blind. So just kind of be aware of what they're using. If they blind the vet, then you know to wait until the enforcer lands. I know that's a lot of that's a bit lofty of a concept, using teamwork to increase your performance, but maybe can keep it in mind. I'm beating the shit out of Bullseye here because I have not unlocked Wascot yet, but I am with him in spirit, so Wascot must die because we love him so much. So I take care of that. Another bouncer. This is pointless what I'm doing. Wait, no, it's not. I guess I didn't have a juice. Yeah, at level 15, it's pretty pointless to go ahead and fight bouncers because they give you 200 health, or 200 health, they give you 200 bucks, but you don't need it because you're already max leveled. And right there, I really would have liked an Inspire heal since I wouldn't have to buy this Regenital, but yeah, you don't always get what you want, so. I pop some Regenital. I would really like, I'd like some little tiny animation. Maybe instead of buying Regenital, you pop open a can of it and drink it. That'd be kind of cool. Like, it's like a soda beverage. I don't really know what kind of product Regenital is, but I think that'd be kind of spiffy. Because right now it just does this weird little animation. It'd be cool if a character just kind of opened the can, drank it, and threw it to the ground. I don't know what I'm thinking. All the animations in this game are really cool anyway, so maybe just another one. I'm adding too much work for them. Whenever they're focusing on things like making the game better and increasing content and stuff, so I'm asking them to do asinine horseshit. Just ignore me, Uber. You're doing fine with all the cool stuff. I really like this game a lot. I get really frustrated sometimes. If I get really frustrated and being a huge cock in match, just ignore me and tell me. Just say, "Slick, you're being a cunt," and I'll remember this commentary, and I'll go, "Oh, I'm probably being a cunt." I'll try to keep my mouth shut. I've been biting my tongue a little bit, but it's kind of annoying. I just get annoyed. Like, if I have a bad day at work, I want to play Superman in Combat, and like, I keep getting matches with levers and fucking a bunch of horseshit keep happening. I can't help but just get frustrated. So if I'm a real douchebag, I guarantee you that right after I'm the huge douchebag, I immediately feel like shit. Right after I get to the lobby menu, I'm like, God, I was a fucking huge asshole for no reason. So just take solace in the fact that I feel like a huge cunt the moment after, right after I get done doing what I'm doing. And know that I try not to be a huge dick. Sometimes I am, but I mean, I do my best. I do my best, guys. Leave me alone. Now that tank went in juice, I go ahead and back off because juicing to take out a jackpot is probably one of the best uses of juice in the game. Depending on the situation, it's just amazing because it melts the jackpot immediately. You get plus 50 rating for dealing with that. And I learned that because I just watched a Gray Fox video, a vet video. So I'm going to steal his tip and pass it off as my own because I am a huge douchebag. Good artists borrow, great artists steal. Now this Carl's going to go ahead and try to block me from getting the chest and kill, and that's okay because I'm going to get him for the kill because he's a huge dickhead. Wait, you're not getting away, dick. That's what you get for making me not kill that chest and asshole. He almost got away, but he stunned himself like a big dope. And that's one of the reasons I run can't stun this on my Carl build. So I can shoot the stun at the ground, stun both of us, but not stun myself because I got can't stun this. I feel like can't stun this is a little bit kind of a, I don't like it as a really as a product. Because stuns, like, just, it basically eradicates some character's abilities. It'd be like if you made, like, a product called, like, Shades or something, where you put it on and all of a sudden blinds don't work. It kind of just immediately just makes a bunch of skills worthless, which I just have mixed feelings about. Now, this tank is definitely not getting away. Fuck you, tank. I keep an eye on my team vision, and a lot of people say that the Irradiate skill from Artemis is kind of shitty, and I'll agree, but if you're a commando, I can imagine it being fucking amazing. Artemis is, I know I probably should have said this in the last video, save your Irradiate for after you've weakened a pro and they are running away. Do that. You see a pro and you know you're going to weaken them and they're going to run away, irradiate them. And maybe a commando and say, hey, use your team chat, go, hey, commando, I irradiated a guy, he's almost dead, get him! And then you can they can track him down and kill him, so I give Irradiate a lot more credit than I think a lot of other people are, and I think you guys should do too. Mostly because it does exactly what I just said. If you have a good commander on your team, it can be really, really vital in ending streaks and really sealing the deal. Now, I know what he's going to do. Oh, you're going to go for the Regenital? No, you're not. Gate flip kick, son. Boom! And right there, that's just reading your opponent. It had nothing to do with skill. That had everything to do with me knowing exactly what he was going to do. Now, what he should have done was seen me and then basically try to juke me out. But he didn't, and so he died. So just try to be unpredictable whenever you're low on health and you know an enemy is chasing you. Do the silly thing if you have to. I go 21-1 with 11 assists, 160 bot kills, which I would propose that that's a lot for a commando. So good job me for getting a bunch of kills and a bunch of bots, and yet I still place not in the lead because the assault got 40 more bot kills than me. So good for that guy for pushing lanes and being all around a cool guy. And then Megabeth, 250 bot kills. Good bot pushing. Without good bot pushing, commandos really can't, they're not very good. So that's this gameplay. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys later.